I'm going to cut that out because that's terrible. That's terrible intro. You're awful. Hello and welcome, especially to all our new subscribers who may be watching us for the first time, and the 100 other loyal fans that will someday let us throw over the government. I've already failed one of those.
But which government?
I could be thinking about a D&D campaign.
Oh, true. Yeah. Okay. Right.
Or FFG.
Or Naboo.
Naboo.
Yeah, they're already screwed. Failed the other one there as well, haven't they?
We literally gave Simon a list of things not to do.
I saw it. It was me that came up with
it. It was as well.
That's not a bad word. There's worse words for me to say.
Yes.
Which I almost very much nearly did say there, which I won't. But anyway, welcome to the Karma Kraken.
Hello.
We are Bad Karma Cards, and we are joined, after a long hiatus, by...
Tyney!
And Sci-Fi. You're probably bored of my voice, because I'm the only one that's been putting up videos. But as we said, 100 subscribers?
Yeah. Yay.
106?
106.
106.
As of today, which is the thingy of thingy.
Yeah. And guess what? You're going to have to watch the entire video to see when we do the draw.
Yeah.
Just to be annoying.
Just to be that extra bit annoying.
Oh, yes.
But it's not going to be at the end, because that'd be easy. You just skip to the end.
Oh, yeah, I suppose. Yeah.
So the competition was to win this last playmat, which is currently slightly obscured. I've had this playmat for so long.
Because it's Mars.
There's a lot of people that like Mars now.
I have seen that, yeah.
And I can also see Anne's face just sort of like, you know.
Twitching. No one likes Mars. It's why they rotated it out. They did rotate it out, didn't they? And I'm not just...
Yeah, they did, yeah. Sanctum of Mars.
Not just, like, hoping in my dreams that Mars is rotated out.
No, your shadows, what are you on about?
I like the fact that I have Mars and Sanctum. Was it off, like...
Have you seen the current map?
No, just
that one. Toga dinosaurs.
Oh, the toga dinosaurs.
It's Imperatus Rex, I think it is.
Oh! Did you see the jumpers and the scarves and the hats and this is plushy as well? I'm getting very excited about this. I'm sorry.
Is this for Vault Tour? Is it? Or...
Yeah, I think so. Like the things you spend your tokens on.
Ooh, I did not see any. Of
oh, it's no, a Christmas jumper with like the toga of dinosaurs and a scarf and a hat, and there's a plushie of an octopusy creature.
Oh, it might be. Oh, what's it called? Where it enters play and you get X number of amber.
Yes, yeah.
On screen now.
Well, Sam remembers his editing. But some of the stuff that had the vault here was amazing. So, yeah.
Better than a gaming chair.
Slightly.
which the guy that won had always had to give back.
Really? I didn't hear about
that. Didn't you hear about that? What was it? He searched his deck for... He either searched his deck or shuffled something into his deck, but he didn't shuffle his deck.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
And he was on the live stream. This is what gets me as well. I was going to mention something about sportsmanship later on, but which I will. But the amount of people that are caught on stream...
Oh, I know.
You have to think, are you doing this in your normal? There's a guy in Final Fantasy TCG, he's been banned for, it's either a year or 6 months, because he got caught cheating, and then tried to backchat the judge that caught him cheating.
Oh my god. No, you don't do that. Jeez Louise, man.
But yeah, you just... There was the other one that was on live stream, there was a guy playing, and literally, Final Fantasy again, he had his backups, but then he sat like that.
Over them?
Yeah, so then when someone got attacked, he goes, oh, well, actually, this backup gives this 1,000 power.
You can't do that.
It got mentioned.
Yeah.
But the fact is...
Like, I'm an elbow wrestler, I will do that. So, yeah, I can see how he did it, but was he doing purposely? Yeah.
Well, there's putting you like that, and then like that.
You've seen none of my forwards.
Have you heard of the fog of war?
Oh, jeez.
On that note, I will get this bit out of the way, because I don't want to dwell on it too much about sportsmanship and all that, but all the games we play have a very key word in it. It's a game.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
They're designed for fun. And I feel everybody should be allowed, at any level of a game, should be felt to made welcome.
Oh, yeah.
And if they have a problem with a game, or if they're struggling with a rule, they should be spoken to... like an adult, like a person.
Yeah.
And you shouldn't have to experience some of the things that I've had to experience, unfortunately, with Keyforge. 99% of Keyforge, everybody's been wonderful, welcoming, lovely.
Yeah.
But there's that 1% that has, at points, made me want to go, done. Mm. And I actually didn't want to bring up Keyforge, but it was Keyforge that set me off quite recently, and I haven't been playing much Keyforge lately, which is a massive shame.
Yeah.
Because it's a wonderful game.
It is.
It's getting very complicated, but it's a wonderful game. Did you know there's a card that interacts with keys now?
Oh, God. Is that what the people say, like, the colour of the keys?
You have to have your keys clearly marked with the colours of red, blue, and yellow. There's a single card.
Just one card?
One card.
Joy.
Because it's from a future set, and there's things now called anomalies.
Oh, right.
Which are cards from future sets in this set.
Oh, no.
I showed you that, what is it? It was like a fish monster thing, and it goes, when the tide is high, it gets this ability, and when the tide is low, it gets this ability. The tide is neither high or low.
Yeah.
Because it's from a future set, and the cards that make you the tide high and low are in that set. If they are in that set, because I've been told that there's a mechanic that has been scrapped, but one of the cards with that mechanic on has made it into this set. So it's sort of like,
Oh, dear. We've not yet played it, have we?
No,
adult and grown-up stuff has happened. In
a lot of things have been going on, hasn't it?
Yeah.
It has.
So
we did go out and buy some, so we are going to try and get some done with them.
We just need to find them again.
I was going to bring some tonight, because obviously Keyforge isn't too hard, because I've got all the keys, the tokens and everything, I could just turn up. But we've got a special surprise.
Oh, yes, we have.
Oh, yes.
Ace. Celebration, as it were. Well,
some could call it that.
Later on, you know, American Beauty, where there's that lass and she's all the rose petals are falling on her. Literally, I want that recreation of what we're going to do later.
Oh, yeah.
But as tasteful as possible.
Oh, yes, that's happening. That's
a Yoda
happening
on each nipple. Not a baby Yoda, because that'd be weird.
That would be weird.
Yes.
God, that meme.
The baby Yoda. Have you seen it, The Mandalorian?
No.
No, we haven't.
That's what's annoying me so much about it.
He's cute, though. He looks pretty baby.
He is like, they look cute, but it's like, why are they all calling him the baby Yoda?
You'll set off. There's two sides of, well, no, I think there's multiple sides of this. There's the people who have had too much baby Yoda, the people who don't understand baby Yoda, the people who don't want to call it baby Yoda.
Isn't he called, like, the child? That's why it is in The Mandalorian.
Yeah, but everybody is calling it Baby Yoda because Yoda's species has never been named. But I've got this feeling that they have been.
No, I Wikipedia'd it before.
Really?
Never named still.
Really? Because there was Knights of the Old Republic, there was a female one.
Yeah.
Yeah, she was just sort of like Yoda's species.
Yeah. And then there was something said about there can only ever be one of them or something like that. Like it's produced by the Force or something. Did you know there's a crazy Dark Sith a Dark Sith Wookiee?
Is there?
That eats other Wookiees.
That's amazing.
In the expanded universe.
That just sounds scary.
On Khajiit, there's parts of the forest where they can only live in the trees, and because underneath is just infested with the dark side.
Yeah.
And that's where they send all their prisoners and everything.
Oh.
Like all the criminals, because it's like, oh, they'll die down there. Yeah. One of them didn't.
Oh, dear.
Okay, so I just did a little Google, and Yoda's species is called Yoda's species.
Oh, dear.
That's it. And
not bothered to name it.
Was that on Wikipedia by any chance?
On Wikipedia.
All right, I was going to say, if it was on Wikipedia, I'm going to go, you can stop asking me for that £2 donation every time I go on now.
No, it's Wikipedia, and the members are a Mitch, an Orteg, a Vanda Okra, a Yaddle, a Yoda, an unidentified Jedi, and the Child.
The child. It's not the Child of Fate, so sorry. I'm going to take my hat off because my head. Did you see my picture last night of the hobby-related incident?
No, what?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Simon sacrificed blood to the, who was it? Which god was it?
Slaanesh.
Yeah, you are.
I think she likes fluids, but not all that fluid.
Mm. Oh, you bought Slaanesh then?
I got some fiends.
Yeah.
A Mauler fiend turned up yesterday, and the guy who's built it has done a terrible job, so I was trying to, like, get the legs off. And one of the legs was a little bit more resistant than the other one. And it's a very spiky model. But as I was saying to a friend, I used to play Legion of Overblight in Priority in War Machine by Priority Press. They are very spiky models, and if you didn't sacrifice blood to them in one way of building them, then they were rubbish on the tabletop. Literally, there's the Throne of Everblight. I'll show you a picture of it later on, and it's this massive tentacle beast on screen now. and it's just got all these like hook spikes all around it, and they're obviously they've been filed down so they're not razor sharp or pointy or anything like that, but they still draw blood.
See, I struggled with flipping Space Marines. They were painful enough to put together, so... Yeah.
And they're push feeder.
I know. Those.
Yeah, it's... I dislike putting together the Death Guard because they're pointy. And I'm like, I don't like pointy models.
I was sat the other day when I was messing about with those Fiends of Slash because I built one of them and I'm sat there going, I don't want to build another one, but there's just too many bits. And I'm there thinking back to the days where Fiends of Slash were like a one-piece, two-piece model or something like that. And I'm like, oh, the glory days.
I think somewhere upstairs I have the very old one, like Space Marines, where they're just like this.
Yeah, static.
It's just static. It's like, it's one mould.
Did you really just do a movement on a podcast?
I did.
That's usually my shtick.
And
we do keep going, oh, look at the face Ant's pulling. It's like, yeah, you can't. Unless we set up like an elaborate maze of mirrors.
So, would we like to discuss this lovely book, Elephant in the Room, Everyone in the Room?
I keep buying the fancy covers.
That's pretty much it.
Well, the fancy covers, I think I heard at some point that the fancy cover is actually the same price as the regular cover.
Yeah, yeah. I said, how much is, at the local store? I'm like, how much is the special art one? And he goes, oh, £38. I'm like, oh. And the lad next to me goes, buy the normal version, it's cheaper. And the guy around the camera goes, no, it's not. It's like, oh, I guess I'll get the special edition one then.
Yeah. I mean, there's some nice stuff. I've not logged in properly as of yet.
So, I'm an idiot and a noob. What is it?
So, it's a setting for D&D.
Airship.
So it's the setting of Eberron. So at the moment, regular D&D is set in, I think it's Forgotten Realms.
Yeah.
Which is Baldur's Gate. Is that Forgotten Realms?
Yeah, it's in Baldur's Gate. Baldur's Gate's in the Forgotten Realms, along with Icedale and Neverwinter.
Icewinddale, thank you very much.
Elitist.
You come in here with your baby Yoda slander.
But yeah, so it's all, that's where generally everything's set. Uh-huh. And then Eberron was another setting that came in during some edition.
Yeah. Okay.
Was originally fan-made and then made its way in.
I was on the fence about buying it, and do you know what's so funny about it? I'm like, oh, can I have a look at it? And I'll look at the back blurb. There's an angry guy with a sword and shield. But it's got airships.
Yeah.
It's got a new class in it.
Steampunky or...?
It's
Magitech.
It's like Magitech type thing. There's lots of things like this. New ways to do races, which is dragon marks, which I never really understood.
Yeah. Are dragon marks also along the lines of like your guild or something like that?
Yeah, so it's...
So you join...
a guild.
Yeah, your party picks a guild and they all get like a benefit from the dragon marks. And yes, I just did a hand action there as well.
But yeah, the new class set in it is really good.
Is that the Artificer?
The Artificer.
Yeah. The guy who like makes magical light.
Yeah.
Magical trinkets or...
So he can make magical items and then he basically imbues items with his magic and then does stuff and I'm still doing hand actions. But yeah, like they make various bits like...
So is there a story in this or like a...
I think there's like a... There is a set of, path to follow along, but
yeah.
The reason I got it is because it's got the new class in, it's got rules for airships, I think, as well, isn't it?
Yeah.
The dragon marks are quite interesting as well. It's like little things, because I'm thinking of running a new D&D campaign, which I'll incorporate bits in.
I've just got new races as well, including the Warforged.
Oh, really?
The Warforged, yeah, which are...
Well, I thought they were in a different book.
They were, so it's weird, right? So there's the Wayfinder's Guide to Eberron that came out and is now no longer available because this book is out.
Right.
So they released the Wayfinder's Guide, which had some rules in for various stuff, and released
it. It was like a compilation.
And it was like a compilation of the stuff. And then they've took that away because they've released this one now.
Okay, cool.
So it was, I think it was through someone else, like another, still affiliated with Wizards and D&D, but they produced it and now this is in. And Warforged are really good. They're just robots, but made out of different stuff.
I think that's what the character on the back was, actually.
It is, yeah. And you can play as a druid, which makes you a transformer.
I will probably be posting a little gif right now of a funny transformer gif. but there's something I found out the other day. It was in regards to gaming controversies of the year or something.
All right.
And it was in relation to Skyrim. Oh no, Elder Scrolls Online, because to promote their latest patch, they also released a RPG game to go along with it.
Yeah.
Which promptly got pulled.
Oh.
Because they copied and pasted from a Wizards of the Coast book.
Oh, I know.
Word for word. That quite literally those pictures of like theirs and the original book that Wizards of the Coast put out.
Yeah.
Side by side, and it was word for word. Same font, everything, and it's just like...
We're just hoping they wouldn't get found out. Like,
yeah, but in this day and age...
that's just dumb.
Yeah.
I don't think they've commented on it yet. I don't know when it happened, but it was sometime this year.
Yeah.
Which, of course, this year's going to an end.
Yeah.
I
don't know. Like 20 days to the end or something?
It's not long.
Not long.
It's the...
20, no, it's 14th.
What? 14th, yeah, so...
It is the 14th.
18 days? Ooh. No, 17 days, sorry.
An amount of days.
Gives us 8 days. 3 by my count. GIF on screen now. I actually really want to go see that reboot.
Yeah?
Jane and Silent Bob's reboot.
I really do. Although I'm a big Jane and Silent Bob.
Jason Matthew looks weird.
Comes out on DVD on the 21st of January.
Does this?
Yeah. Really?
Jesus.
When was it even in the cinema?
End of November, I think I missed it.
I didn't even see it advertised.
Well, I think mostly they only had like one probably thing on a USB stick, and that's why you went to it. Oh, sorry, Kevin, I love you, but like that's probably the reason why you ordered two, wasn't it?
There was something in the news the other week about the fights outside of cinemas down in Birmingham over a gangster film or something.
No.
Yeah. It does lead on to something geeky, this, don't worry. But they're on about that they've taken down the screenings of a film, like Blue something, I can't remember what it was called. I don't really want to give it any.
Yeah.
But they were fighting because gangs or something. So that was what was reported in our country.
Yeah.
I was like, all right. People in America and Canada thought the fighting was over Frozen 2 because it came out at the same time. So people were having machete fights over Frozen 2. And I'm sat there watching a streamer say this with a straight face, and I'm there going, idiot. You idiot.
I mean, it would make it more interesting. You're in a fight about Frozen 2.
Elsa's the best.
No, Anna.
I will send you a link about Kratos versus Elsa.
Oh my god.
It does not go the way you think it does. I'll show you it right after this video, actually, because it's quite funny. But we're getting a little bit off. Anyway, we were talking about everyone.
Yeah.
Yes.
In that vein, there will be a D&D thing, hopefully, in the new year starting, called the Host Club, which will essentially be people sat around a table recording D&D for the channel. I don't know how that's going to work or how it's going to... I've had lots of people say they're interested in doing it.
Yeah.
I would like to try and get you guys in it as well. It's just getting everybody at the same time and then trying to figure out how what format it would go in.
It's a really good idea, though.
Just
The other idea, the continuation of the idea as well, it won't be massively long campaigns, or if it is, it'll be like week on, week off, da-da-da-da. And then there'll be chance for different systems to be used, not just D&D. And different DMs as well.
Yeah.
So like a rotation, and hopefully bring you that content, because D&D is the hot. I almost swore there again. It's the hot tamales currently. This is really hard for me, especially where I work now, where everybody where I work currently, every other word is a swear word, and I've got even worse from working there. But
hot tamales.
I remember a random compliment I was using years ago today. It was like, I like you, you are warm. And it's like, why did I stop using that? That's awesome. But Host Club, hopefully, the first setting is going to be one of my own creation, which is going to be using various sources, hot sources. We're going to get quite a few, hopefully, some new people to it, just to show how accessible D&D is and how fun it can be.
Yeah. So, like, I've got Dungeons and Doggos, which I am desperate to DM. So
yeah. I actually really want to play that as well.
Yeah. Right. So that'd be a good way to do one shot
sized adventure. Yeah. I have an idea that I've had for a long time after I saw one monster in a monster manual, and I'm like, I need to run a game about that monster.
Sort of off topic, but I was using a random map for my last D&D campaign, and literally they were going across a river, and these two like lobster things, like Cthulhu tentacles, popped up, and these guys were in a boat and they were fighting. I got reminded about this the other day because someone goes, "How do you do a fight in a rowboat?" And a lot of people were going very hard, and I'm like, "Well, the first thing you do is you make sure that your wizard doesn't forget that water conducts electricity because is it Visage of the Dragon or something? He essentially made his face into a dragon.
Yeah.
And then you choose what dragon it is, and then that's what breath it does. So he chose Blue Dragon, which is electricity.
Yeah.
And he sat there at the back of the boat, and then quite literally I'm sat there with my hands over my face going, half your party's in the water currently.
Oh, no.
Do you know what water does with electricity? And he's like, what do you mean? Water conducts electricity.
Literally dropping a torso into the water. Isn't
yeah.
It?
And by the way, these things have been thrashing around. You're covered in water too. And he's like, and literally, the action he did was he just sat down, folded his arms, and like, I'll stay at the back of the boat then. Until it wears off or something like that.
There's a dragon face just soaking.
I know you want to do it, but you can't.
Just tell the party to jump.
Oh, right, it's fine. Okay.
No joke, half of them were in the water.
Jump out of it. Right.
The best thing was the warlock went, I will use this spell that levitates me 10 foot in the air. And I'm like, check the monster's height and everything. The monster reaches up, grabs you and throws you back into the boat.
Right. And on the other side of the table is...
The blob that ate everything. From Arkham Horror.
So, do we get to discuss this, like, at all?
Well, there's bits of... So, obviously, I went to Arkham Knight, which was a tasty, tasty weekend.
I think we can... It was IQ Games that ran it, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was IQ Games who ran it. They ran it the year before as well.
Mm.
And there was a lot... of games there to demo. I demoed Marvel Champions, because weirdly that was on for demo, at an Arkham event. Arkham Final Hour, which Arkham Final Hour is really good. It's the entirety of Arkham Horror, the big board game, condensed down, all the story ripped out, and it's just the mechanics. So you can blitz through it in an hour.
I've seen it on sale on quite a few places.
Yeah, it is quite cheap. It's well worth picking up because it's just a big puzzle. Like, as long as you can solve the puzzle and you can keep on top of the puzzle, you're fine, you can play through it.
Yeah.
But the big draw was the blob that ate everything, which everyone got as part of their kit, along with a nice deck box, a single alt art of level 0 shortcut. I would really have preferred 2.
It was the people's argument with that last Arkham Knight's invocation, wasn't it? With you get like 1 and 1 when it's like you want to run 2.
Yeah, usually you run 2s in a set, but that's the point. You then got some tokens for Arkham Final Hour, which I still don't own. So I've got some acrylic tokens for that I don't need. Some damage and sanity acrylic tokens. 2 sets of dice. And a Elder Sign pin. And this pack, which I've since told my local shop, don't order me this, I have it already. Don't add this to my subscription.
Don't at me. Did anybody get the playmat?
So there was no playmat at Arkham Knights.
That's a shame. That's the one thing I really wanted to do. Not that I need any more playmats.
No. There's,
like, the new invocation kit that's been announced, which I believe being running, well, our local shop is running next year.
Yeah.
Comes with deck boxes, a mountain of promo cards, and one player mat.
One
player mat.
How the hell do they decide who gets that then?
So I don't know whether it's the organizer gets the player mat or if it is a big four player player mat.
Which you then get to take a pair of scissors to at the end.
Or you go, who's going to do the thing?
Unless it's like some sort of competitive aspect to it.
I don't know, because there's no competitiveness to the game. But everyone gets a big deck box and everyone's going to get like a selection of promos.
You say there's no competitive aspect, but at UK Games Expo this year, there was a competition, wasn't there, with Arkham?
Yeah.
So they can make it.
I mean, that was done by a podcast people who set that up, so they might pull them in and get to do it again. I mean, they had people in from Arkham Horror Podcast make a scenario, which was the murder at the Excelsior Hotel, which I've still got to play.
That's
pretty good.
To be honest, I've because of the way things happened with L5 Arkham now, I fell behind massively with Arkham Horror, and I would like to catch up playing it again, but...
Once you fall behind it, it's hard to catch up.
Well, I was looking the other day at L5R, because I neglected that as well, and I'm like, yeah, no, not a chance.
No, not a chance.
The Marvel Champions, it had two hero packs, a scenario pack, and they've announced another scenario pack, another hero pack, and apparently they're all going to come out very close together because of, like, production delays, which is going to be a bit of a pain, but...
Yeah.
Just FFG, they usually struggle sometimes with...
Some stuff.
They set it out, they plan it out, and then it just doesn't ever go to plan.
Yeah.
But I think we should play Arkham Horror again on the channel sometimes, at least like give people an introduction to how to play it.
Oh, yes. One funny thing to do that would be great is to play the Blob Day everything. It has a mechanic where it eats things.
Yeah.
That's not just stuff in the game.
Oh.
This is... It eats things in the real world. So we had a tournament...
Are we actually tapping through to Cthulhu?
Yeah. So in the tournament, event, there was, I think, probably about 112 players.
Yeah.
For it on the Saturday, which was the one I was in. And it ate the light. So you had everyone all in one area and lights go out. Everyone freaks out because suddenly no nerds can see their cards. And it's like, what's happened?
I want to think how many people just jumped up and screamed, "Stranger Danger." Oh, get off my cards and punch them.
There was a lot of people just going, what's going on? And then all you looked around was everyone's phones just suddenly went boop, 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 boop. That all that the light was allowed.
You know what made it funny? Just to unnerve everybody, you just hear a fizzy drink open and they're like, I shouldn't joke, I suffer from anxiety, which I'm sure a lot of nerds do. So. Yeah.
But it's
the concept of time? And...
Yeah, so it can eat a person's concept of time.
It also ate Pablo, the small Mexican child that I brought to the event.
Yeah, it can.
oh no, Pablo! Into the trash.
It can eat your hand, like not just like hand thing, but like your hand.
I'm sorry, but Slanesh has already claimed this hand.
Your deck box, your sleeves. So if your character in sleeves is like,
is it judging my fashion repertoire?
Yeah, so it's like, oh, your character is like, nope, I eat the sleeve. And if you can't fulfil that thing, then it has to eat something else. and it's got a massive table of stuff.
So how do you it eats your sleeve? What, do you have to rip the sleeve off you?
No, the sleeve off your card.
Oh, right.
Not off your shirt.
Sorry, I'm there going, that's why I looked at my arm. It's like, but it's old, but I like this hoodie.
But it's a well funny event.
They come fun to play.
If it eats the lights while we're trying to
play. Oh, yeah, could you imagine?
But if it eats those lights, it's fine because we're using it separately.
Separate light.
We'll set up both lights so it needs that one, so we'll turn the other one on.
We'll beat you up.
Where have I put the remote control?
Aha. Uh-huh.
Aha. It's got a fancy thing.
It eats the light. I did that without moving from my seat.
Oh, it's technology.
Yes. Speaking of technology, you mentioned something earlier, actually, didn't you?
So I got a fancy new phone.
Ooh.
It is now hacked.
Probably is. Which has got a useful feature for all wargamers. It has got a smart measure feature.
Hacks.
Which means I can go, how far away is that?
Hacks.
It is 6 inches. I can shoot it now.
See, my immediate thought was naughty. So, yeah.
It can't pick them up. But if it can, it could break it as a 3D... Well,
just you said it. You said it could take 3D pictures.
It can't take 3D pictures.
So, that particular type of picture has just evolved.
Yeah. No, it can look like it's coming right at you.
What, like Jaws 36?
Oh my word, it's amazing. The future is amazing.
I think there's one or two tournaments that I think you're banned from having your phone out. Hmm. But, which is going to be quite funny because quite a lot of people, especially in like 40K, you do your arm lists on your phone, like on Battlescribe and stuff like that. So to ban a phone. Oh, you can print them out, I suppose.
You can print them out.
Yeah, so there's no real...
Or use a classic pen and paper.
How dare you?
You're troglodyte.
Right. So, is it time?
I was just going to say, random time in the middle. So, do you have the generator?
I do. Hang on, let me just not unlock my phone on screen. There we go. Yep.
Right, so hit it multiple times and then reveal what it says.
So what's the number one for? Maximum.
I told you before the stream. I didn't want to tell you on the stream.
Alright.
One moment.
Yeah, I thought it was, sorry. Just double checking. Alright.
That'll do.
Yep. Six.
Number six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alright, I can't pronounce that. The lucky winner of this Mars Playmat, which I'll try and get in contact with you and I'll post it every other way, is Leshrac Banehallow. That's a D&D name.
That is an amazing name.
Leshrac Banehallow. So I will try and contact you. We'll post up everywhere that we can that you've won the mat. I'll try and get in contact with us and we'll try and arrange getting the mat out to you.
Yeah.
Please don't live somewhere weird like Uzbekistan or...
Zimbabwe.
Well, me sending a tube is probably going to look a bit dodgy if I send it. Oh, look, Mother Russia. Do you like anthrax? Yes, you do.
I'm so happy we've reached 100 subscribers.
I know, the next hurdle. And, well, unless 500 would be nice.
Yeah.
But I did some research as to when we can actually quit our jobs and...
Oh, God.
Yeah. We're a long way off that. At least being taken seriously enough to get press passes to events.
Oh, yeah, that'd be nice.
Yeah. But thank you for supporting us.
Oh, yes.
Oh, please continue to support us and ask questions or leave comments. If there's anything you'd like to see us play, say.
Mm-hmm.
I think majority of our followers have come from either Keyforge or Final Fantasy.
Yeah.
Probably more Keyforge. So we are going to do a lot more Keyforge.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
Especially, I want to do a series where, quite literally, I've been to a lot of Star Championships. I want to get all the Star Championship decks that I've got and play them against each other. And obviously see how older decks stack up to newer decks.
I like the one you said before, so, ranking ranky, sort of like.
Yeah.
You've got decks that are like amazing on ranky, and you've played and you're going, this is not good.
It's so, not like this.
Well,
this
the, is bad. The deck that I came second with in a Star Championship at Midland Miniatures, it's got a ranky rating of 4.4 out of 100.
My word.
And I came second with
you
it.
Came second, yeah. So that's what I mean, sort of like showing that sort of thing, that ranky.
Well, what was it? Is it my 7 Plague deck is a ranky rating of 3.6 or something like that? To be honest, I've played it a few times, I can sort of understand it, like, because Plague Rats aren't as amazing. Like, more walls, they're the way forward.
Oh, and more, as a more walls now.
Well, for me, my first deck was more walls at the Beanie Star Championship.
Yeah.
Just the fact that you can. I had 5 in the deck, I think, so you can play one, play another one, it readies up the first one, yeah. You reap. You play another one, you ready up the first two, reap. Oh, play the third one, ready up the other three, reap. So that gives you 1, 2, 3, 6 ambers straight off the bat.
Something like that, yeah?
Yeah.
So if you've already got an amber in your pool, you then just go, keep charge.
My word, that's amazing.
Yeah, I won quite a few games where they're going, oh, you win next turn, do you? Merwolf, 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 key charge. And they're just like...
Sapphire, here to ruin your turn.
There's one thing that... that tournament as well, where quite literally I beat somebody and they literally, you beat me because my deck was bad. I'm like, yeah, that's always what you want to hear, isn't it? not that I absolutely smashed you. Yeah, I won the game, but to have somebody turn around and go, yeah, you only won because my deck's bad is like.
But no, we're definitely saying 2020 is Bad Karma's sort of year, isn't it? We're gonna.
Out the gates, running as if we've stolen something.
Probably have.
Where do you think I got the kit, the playmat from? Why do you think I'm trying to offload it on YouTube?
Well, we shouldn't have.
But yeah, so new year, so we've got more Key Fudge.
More Key Fudge.
Arkham, hopefully, D&D, more Final Fantasy, more I've come up with a new recipe, Tyney Tries.
Tyney Tries.
Because we've got Pokemon to try for that.
Yes.
Open to suggestions. Anything else that I missed?
We've got a massive back out of the game, so just grab a random one.
Tainted Grail.
Tainted Grail.
Oh, yes.
Which I'll check with the creator and make sure we are okay putting up videos of the full campaign, as long as we put a spoiler warning up. Because what they've done is they know the Facebook community are obviously putting up pictures and they went, please do not spoil the game. Because it's meant to be this entire story-driven thing. However, the way people have been getting around it is we've gone, here is a pre-built template of how big you need to make your Facebook page, like status, on the thing to avoid spoilers, to put spoilers at the end. Yeah. And they're fine with that as long as people say, this is a spoiler, don't click if you don't want to know.
They do a similar thing in Arkham Horror, don't they, in the groups and all that. Where it goes, spoilers below.
Or spoilers in the comments. And it gives people a chance. So just basically telling everyone, I think if we put up a thing saying, be aware this is spoiler.
Yeah,
But people will probably want to watch and see how we do.
Yeah, at the... in the same vein as well, because that's one of your Kickstarters that's turned up. Bloodborne's due this year. I want to do something similar to Bloodborne.
Yeah.
Blackstone Fortress I would like to do a playthrough of as well.
Yes.
I think we can only do it with 3 people, but 4 people is ideal. There's a new way to play it that's been released as well. Escalation or something, I think it's called. But again, I think it'll be something where it's like, there may be spoilers.
Yeah. It's the same with The Lord of the Rings, which they actually released a new mode for that as well the other day.
Yeah.
Which is adventure mode for those who don't really want it to be a game, but more want to explore everywhere. And it's called adventure mode. It's still the same story, still the same way that it plays, just easier. So it's like a really easy mode.
Right.
And it gives you more chance to explore and taste and eat, fill in the world and stuff like that.
Well, I do like to fill in.
And then there's... Vampire Heritage.
I saw you back that the other day and I'm like, I'll let him have it.
Yeah. Because it's jumped on it on a late backer. So the pledge manager closed yesterday on that. And it is 21 games that you will play over a 700-year campaign in a full legacy style. So cards will get modified, removed permanently, stuff like that. So it's an interesting campaign and process to go through and see how it all goes.
I had a quick... It sounds interesting. It'll be down to execution, obviously.
Yeah.
We will put it through its paces.
Yeah.
Much like we will with all the other games.
Yeah. We've got a massive list, haven't we?
We do, we have a big list.
I need to try and teach you how to play 40k as well. I'm not sure if we'll do that on camera, but I do need to try and teach you how to play 40k still.
I do have lots of 40k from Conquest, and it's mostly built. But I have no idea what I'm doing.
It's
nice to build. A bit pointy, though.
Yeah, I'll crack out the Legion of Immobile again. You'll see plenty. there was something else that popped in my mind as well. What was it?
Bad Karma Productions. Looking to make a... You're looking to make games, aren't you?
Yes.
You've got a game bubbling in your head somewhere, haven't you?
Yeah,
like a few.
Yeah. I'm in the process of trying to make a game. But I'm... keep getting stuck on... Well, not stuck on the lore. I keep starting doing the lore and then just drop, not doing anything. I still literally need somebody there just... Yeah. Bad Simon.
Nice, keep coming up with mechanics.
But
and,
no lore.
And ideas and no lore.
There's a magical unification or something like that.
Yeah, we could literally... I'm struggling to do everything by myself, so literally I would generally love help, or especially... volunteers to play test or at least bounce ideas off.
Oh, yes.
I've had loads of people say they're happy to listen to ideas. It's just you say an idea, and this is no insult to them at all, because that I love people, the people that I speak to, but when they go, that's a great idea, it's not constructive.
No, you want an answer as to how, what it is, how it works, stuff like that.
Little known fact, I've written two books, and I remember somebody reading one of my books and going, it was all right. It's not the worst I've read. And I'm sat there going, well, what obviously that means there was something wrong with it. What was wrong with it? And he's like, eh.
Oh, good.
I'm like,
that's great. That's how I improve.
Yeah, but I was thinking, this is a thought I had the other day. Being a creator of any sort, and this is YouTube, being singing, all that. It's one thing producing something. It's then seemingly forcing other people to look at it.
Yeah.
With art or painting, it's not too... Because you can look at it and instantly take it in. And it's like, I like that. I don't like that.
Yeah.
The shading's a bit off. Da, 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 da. With writing or YouTube, people have to sit there and...
Actually, take it in.
Yeah, absorb it.
Time to it.
And then to just go, eh, it was all right. Or... I would love somebody to go, oh, I've read your book. I really like this character because this character I didn't like. That would be brilliant. I'd love somebody to do that.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, I've never had that, and it's really... It makes me cry.
Oh.
It doesn't. There's lots of things that make me cry, but that's not one of them.
God.
Tell me how you're so creative, Simon. Torture, mostly self-inflicted. Torment, that was it, sorry.
Yeah.
But there was something else as well, but it's completely gone out. Oh, that's it.
Who's got it?
Final Fantasy TCG Fan Fiesta next month, down near London. It's not in London, it's outside of London. It's hosted by Dicing on the Cake. I am thinking of being there if anybody is going to be along. I'm not too sure if I'm going to do any coverage of it or anything like that, but it seems like a fun event. Crystal Cup's on this weekend, which I can't go to, unfortunately. But this one seems to be a little bit more of a laid-back affair, so I might be down for that.
Yeah, cool.
Because I'm always down for a bit of Final Fantasy TCG.
Yeah.
If only to play at Felthanos and just watch my opponent go, oh. Wait, anything else?
Just say, Aircon is 3 months away.
Yay!
And UK Games Expo is released the tickets and all that much. I can't remember how far it is.
It's end six, of May, beginning
yeah,
of June.
6 months-ish.
Yeah.
So, soon! Very soon.
Soon.
I'm the most excited person on the planet for it.
Oh, there's obviously there's Vault Tour that's at Birmingham. Mm-hmm. Then there's also the UK tournament, UK Championship at Milton Keynes.
All right.
I have no idea why they've picked Milton Keynes. They've turned around and said it's more accessible to people. It's really not. It's like the Crystal Cup going, oh, we didn't want to do it in Wales, so we'll do it in Norwich. Norwich! Has anybody not in Norwich ever tried to get to Norwich? It's like the bloody Bermuda Triangle.
And on that happy note.
they held the UK Nationals for Final Fantasy TCG at Sheffield. Wonderful. That's actually middle of the country.
Yeah, yeah.
Anyway, on that note, there's a, Primes are coming up as well, actually.
Yeah.
Which are like, I guess they're the regionals now, aren't they?
I think so.
Because I don't think there's regionals anymore. I think they're just primes.
Mm.
It's just an FFG thing, I think. I think they changed it to...
Rename things.
Yeah, they've got the store championships, which every store has, and then the primes, which only a couple of shops have got.
Oh, okay. Fair enough.
Apart from Patriot Games Sheffield, that announced three in a row. In a row. For different systems, but...
Yeah.
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 That's it. Again, thank you for 106.
Yay!
Yeah.
We were going to get a party popper. Did you just call all of our fans poofs?
Yes. Yes, I did. Thank you, Matt.
We love you either way.
Yeah.
Yes.
And thank you for joining us. And stay tuned for a very special surprise.
Yes.
The whole... I can't do math. 36 times 5 is 180?
Yeah, sounds about right.
Yeah, 180.
Nope.
Look at your fancy new phone that has rebelled against you.
Rebels against me. You were exactly right.
Oh.
It's almost as if I can do math.
One of us has to.
Don't you work on measurements all day?
Yes.
Okay. Anyway, thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Bye.
See you all next time.
Bye.